बात वहां पर यहीं पे खत्म हुई है. फर्स्ट कंडीशन इज चोन. नाउ अनदर पॉइंट वेयर द प्राइस राइजेस बट स्टिल द डिमांड रिमेन सेम, राइट? इफ इट वुड हैव बीन मूवमेंट देन क्वांटिटी शुड हैव बीन दिस Q1 लाइंग ऑन द सेम कर्व, बट द क्वांटिटी डिड नॉट डिक्रीज, सो इट मींस डिमांड इज लाइंग ऑन द अदर कर्व और कर्व टुवर्ड्स द राइट. यू कैन सी इट इज शिफ्टिंग टुवर्ड्स द राइट और इट इज मूविंग फॉरवर्ड, सो इट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज moving forward and also known as the increase in demand. This is a diagrammatic representation in your book. You might have only this much, right? These conditions are not drawn, means showing only the first condition, but you have to be careful, draw both the conditions. Okay, now we can study the causes. What may be the causes? Causes are actually all the factors, all the determinant except the price, maybe due to the change in any of these factors, right? First could be rise in the income. If the income of the buyer has increased, then he will buy more even at a higher price, or he may buy more at the same price. Then rise in the price of substitute. Maybe the price of the substitute has increased, so he starts buying more at the same price. Like if coffee becomes more expensive, maybe more people start buying tea without the price of tea being changed. Similarly, fall in the price of complementary goods. Then it could be favorable taste and preference. Could be expectation, of rise in price in future. So these may be the reasons for the rightward shift. So if you are asked a question, state any one cause of increase in demand or rightward shift or forward shift, any one of them may be the reason, right? But for the movement part, only one reason is there, that is the price, no other reason, and here you do not have the price. And for the leftward shift, they will be opposite: fall in income, rise in the price of fall in the price of substitute good, rise in the price of complementary good, unfavorable, and so on, right? So next we will study the leftward shift. Leftward shift means that again it has two parts. Less is demanded at same price. And same is demanded at a lower price. Right? If the consumer decreases his demand at the same price, or even if the price falls, then also he doesn't buy the commodity. Like again, you can remember the example of the television set. The box type, right? The price has fallen by many folds, right? If you had to buy it when it was in taste and preference or when it was in fashion, it was around 14, 15, even 20,000. Now you get it for 5,000, then also you don't buy it, right? So even the price has decreased, but the demand is not increasing. Demand is not neither same, it has actually decreased. Again, this also can be represented with the help of a diagram. Again, you can see this is my original demand curve, DD. This is the original quantity, this is the original price. Suppose the quantity decreases at the same price, then it is the first condition, and joining it from here you get the second condition, right? First condition is when less is demanded at the same price, and second is when same is demanded at the lower price. The causes again, this is the opposite of the right version. Rok there, kitna kitne baje.